Welcome all of you to my channel ePhysics for you. In this video, we will be discussing a very important topic on electricity. Today's topic is Thevenin's theorem. I am trying to represent this theorem in a very simple way so that you can understand it very well. Before discussing this theorem, we will see what is Thevenin's theorem and for what purpose is it used. Suppose this is a linear DC circuit. Here, Vs is the voltage source, which has fixed EMF, and R1, R2, and R3 are the fixed resistance. But here, RL is not fixed, it is variable. So, its value depends on what kinds of power appliance is attached to it. It can be a fan, bulb, etc. Now, our object is how much current is flowing through this load resistance and how much voltage will be the drop across this resistance. You will find these values by applying KCL and KVL law. But this process will be a little time consuming and boring because there will be many equations and variables. So to overcome this complication, Thevenin gave us this theorem. This theorem states that any complex linear network can be converted to an equivalent network where only one voltage source VTH and one resistance RTH will be connected in series with the load resistance, where VTH is the open circuited voltage between the required two terminals called the Thevenin's voltage, and the RTH is the Thevenin's equivalent resistance as seen from the load terminals, where all sources are replaced by their internal resistance. This theorem also used where maximum power is required from the source. Simplifying this circuit using Thevenin's theorem is as easy as eating a chocolate. You need to be followed just few steps. Now we want to calculate how much current is flowing through this resistance and how much voltage is dropping across this resistance. We will follow a few steps to calculate it by this theorem. Step number one says that remove this load resistance or this variable resistance of this given circuit. After removing this load resistance, we will get this circuit. Now we want to see the second step, which says that replace all the sources by their internal resistance. In this circuit, we will replace this voltage source by its internal resistance. And step number three says that if the sources are ideal, then short circuit the voltage source and open circuit the current source. For convenience of calculation, here we assume that this voltage source is ideal. We already know that the internal resistance of an ideal voltage source is zero. So we will shorten it. After shortening this circuit, the circuit looks like this. Now we will see step number four, which says that find the equivalent resistance at the load terminal known as Thevenin's resistance. Now we will calculate the value of equivalent resistance between two terminals. When we look from this side, that is, we calculate the value of RTH. Here we see that R1 and R3 connected in parallel. So their equivalent resistance connected in series with R2. So the equivalent resistance of this circuit will be RTH is equals to R1 parallel with R3 plus R2. So we will get R1 R3 divided by R1 plus R3 plus R2. Now we will see the step number 5, which says that find the equivalent voltage by the circuit analysis method. Let's see what will be the value of equivalent voltage across this terminal. That is, we calculate the value of VTH. Since AB terminal is open circuited, so no current can flow through the resistance R2. So the voltage across the AB terminal is same as the voltage drop across the R3, as they are in parallel. By applying KVL law in this circuit, we will get from this loop Vs equals to I into R1 plus R3. So the value of I will be Vs divided by R1 plus R3. Now we want to calculate voltage drop across this resistance. So the value of voltage drop across this resistance will be, we can write it V3 equals to I into R3. If we put the value of I in this equation, we will get Vs into R3 divided by R1 plus R3, which can be written as VTH. This is the simplifier circuit. Here in this circuit, RTH, RL connected in series with VTH. Step number 7 says that find the current flowing through this resistance. Finally, we will see how much current is flowing through this load resistance. By applying KVL law in this circuit, we will get VTH is equals to IL into RTH plus RL. So we will get the value of IL is equals to VTH divided by RTH plus RL. Now we want to see how much voltage is dropping across this resistance. So the value of voltage drop across this resistance will be, we can write it VL equals to IL into RL. If we put the value of IL in this equation, we will get VTH RL divided by RTH plus RL. So how easily we get these values? By applying Thevenin's theorem. We take this example to better understand this theorem. Here we have Vs equals to 6 volt, R1 equals to 10 volt, R2 equals to 15 volt and R3 equals to 12 volt. And the variable resistance RL is 100 ohm. Now our aim is to calculate how much current is flowing through this resistance. First, we calculate the value of Thevenin's equivalent resistance. That is the value of RTH. Since we have found out the formula of RTH, we just put this value in this equation and we will get, by calculating this value, 20.45 ohm. Now we want to calculate the value of VTH across this terminal. As we get this formula little earlier, we put these values in this equation and by calculating this value, we will get 3.27 volt. This is the equivalent network of this circuit. Now we want to calculate how much current is flowing through this resistance, that is the value of IL. As we get this equation little earlier, so we can put these values in this equation and we will get this. By calculating this value, we will get 0.0271 ampere. So this amount of current flow through this resistance. This theorem cannot be applied to the all circuits or networks because it has some limitations. So the limitation of this theorem are, first, it cannot be applied to these non-linear networks. Second, it cannot be used for determining the efficiency of the circuit. Third, also it is not applicable to the unilateral networks. And fourth, there should not be magnetic coupling between RTH and RL.